Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel. Some more updates for you tonight. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have published a touching statement calling for unity and solidarity during the current global situation. In a post on their Instagram, the couple said that it was important that people search for the truth and support one another during these uncertain times. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle started their post by saying, "These are uncertain times," they said. "And now, more than ever, we need each other. We need each other for truth, for support, and to feel less alone during a time that can honestly feel quite scary. There are so many around the world who need support right now, who are working tirelessly to respond to this crisis behind the scenes, on the front line, or at home. Our willingness, as a people, to step up in the face of what we are all experiencing with COVID-19 is awe-inspiring. This moment is as true a testament there is to the human spirit. We often speak of compassion. All of our lives are in some way affected by this, uniting each of us globally. How we approach each other and our communities with empathy and kindness is indisputably important right now. Over the coming weeks, this will be our guiding principle." Prince Harry and Meghan Markle also confirmed that they will be doing their bit by posting accurate news and facts on their social media channels over the coming weeks. They wrote, "We will be sharing information and resources to help all of us navigate the uncertainty, from posting accurate information and facts from trusted experts, to learning about measures we can take to keep ourselves and our families healthy, to working with organizations that can support our mental and emotional well-being. In addition, we will focus on the inspiring stories of how so many of you around the world are connecting in ways big and small to lift all of us up. We are all in this together, and as a global community, we can support each other through this process and build a digital neighborhood that feels safe for every one of us. We look forward to sharing more over the days and weeks to come." Meghan returned to Canada to reunite with son Archie after last Monday's Commonwealth Day service. Prince Harry, who stayed in the UK longer to attend meetings at Buckingham Palace, reportedly flew to Canada a few days later. The couple had briefly returned to the UK to carry out their final string of engagements before their royal duties come to an end on March 31st. Because of the coronavirus outbreak, Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau recommended that all Canadians avoid non-essential travel outside of the country until further notice, and that all travelers to Canada self-isolate for 14 days upon entry, with exceptions for workers who are essential to the movement of goods and people. Trudeau announces Canada will shut borders to foreign nationals.
Hello everyone, bonjour tout le monde. Over the past few days, we've seen COVID-19 spread around the world at an even faster pace. Canada is no exception. We will be denying entry to Canada to people who are not Canadian citizens or permanent residents. This measure will carve out some designated exceptions, including for air crews, diplomats, immediate family members of Canadian citizens, and at this time, US citizens. Air operators will be formally mandated to prevent all travelers who present symptoms of COVID-19 to board a plane. Air operators will be required to complete a basic health assessment of every air traveler based on guidance from the Public Health Agency of Canada. This means that anyone who has symptoms will not be able to come to Canada. I know this news will spark concern among Canadians traveling abroad. I want to assure you that our government will not leave you unsupported. To help asymptomatic Canadians return home, our government will set up a support program for Canadians who need to get on a plane. Canadian travelers will be able to get financial assistance to help them with the costs of returning home or temporarily covering their basic needs while they wait to come back to Canada. Starting Wednesday, March 18th, only 4 Canadian airports will be accepting international flights: Toronto Pearson, Montreal Trudeau, Vancouver International Airport, and Calgary International Airport. At this time, domestic flights, as well as flights coming from the US, Mexico, the Caribbean, and Saint-Pierre-et-Miquelon, will not be affected. The travel restrictions announced today will not apply to commerce or trade. We will continue to ensure the supply of important goods to Canada. These measures will help save lives. The economic impact of this pandemic is shifting hourly, and we recognize the stress and anxiety that it is causing. As I've said, we are prepared to see Canadians through this time. We will have additional measures to announce as early as tomorrow to support Canadians, particularly our most vulnerable. I want to remind all Canadians that they should avoid non-essential travel outside of our country until further notice. Canadian travelers should return to Canada via commercial means while it is still possible to do so. Let me be clear. If you're abroad, it's time for you to come home. If you've just arrived, you must self-isolate for 14 days. And finally, all Canadians, as much as possible, should stay home. Merci beaucoup tout le monde. Bonne journée.
Another analysis. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are said to feel immense relief now they have stepped back as senior royals, a source has claimed. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex announced earlier this year they want to split their time between the UK and North America and become financially independent. A source told People, this is what Meghan and Harry have always wanted, to create their own life. It's got to feel like an immense relief to get out of the UK and go down their own path. The couple are currently residing in a $14 million waterside mansion on Vancouver Island, after their last public engagement at the Commonwealth Service in London on March 9th. Since the move, the Duke and Duchess have the freedom to do whatever they want, because the locals don't bother them, according to the source. A source told us, Meghan has no regrets and the sky's the limit. She and Harry feel like a huge weight has been lifted. We've been spending quality time together as a family. Meghan has been cooking and making homemade baby food for Archie. As the couple embark on their new life together, it is thought that they could put up roots in Meghan's native Los Angeles. A source previously told People, they love being in Canada, but they are looking at houses in Los Angeles too. They'll likely have houses in both places. Insiders have claimed the new parents have even eyed up renting Kylie Jenner's old $8 million Malibu mansion. It was previously thought their time could be split equally on each side of the pond, but it is now speculated the couple will predominantly reside on the western side of the Atlantic, with fleeting trips to the UK. Meghan has previously raved about the warm reception she had when she relocated to Toronto from Los Angeles when she landed the role of Rachel Zane in legal drama Suits. Writing on her now-defunct blog The Tig, the actress said, "The people are so kind, I love the food scene, and I really love exploring little nooks around the city with my two dogs. I love how much green space there is tucked away. You wouldn't expect that, and it reminds me of Los Angeles in a lot of ways." However, Meghan also praised California, saying, "I was born and raised in Los Angeles, a California girl who lives by the ethos that most things can be cured with either yoga, the beach, or a few avocados." In other news,
as of April 1, 2020, the Sussexes will no longer be senior working members of the royal family. As a result, they will no longer be beholden to royal rules, and they will also become financially independent while focusing on projects and charity work that speaks to them. Though the pair have already been testing out normal life since late 2019 while living on Vancouver Island in Canada, royal experts are concerned that Prince Harry will find life post-Mexit too challenging. Royal experts and Queen Elizabeth are deeply concerned about Mexit. Though the Sussexes seem happier than they've ever been, what they are doing is unprecedented. As a result, no one, including Queen Elizabeth, believes that Mexit will actually work. Of course they are besotted with each other, royal expert Camilla Tonini told us. But that's not to say the love they have for each other and their child and their dream life in North America, that they're not going to face challenges. And that it's not going to be difficult, particularly for Prince Harry to leave everything that he's known. This is an institution he was born into. He knows nothing else. Additionally, the Queen has put a 12-month review clause in the Sussexes' Mexit agreement. Putting that 12-month review in place goes to show you that the Queen will be watching them like a hawk. Julie Montague, Viscountess, Hinchingbrooke, said in the Channel 5 documentary, Royals, A Family in Crisis. She will want to see everything that they are doing, what they are making money from, and how it is affecting the royal family. So there must be some concern from the Queen about what their intentions are. Many royal experts are convinced that the Duke and Duchess, or at least Prince Harry, will eventually return to the royal fold. Prince Harry thinks he's more normal than the rest of his family. Though he's been a member of the British royal family for his entire life, the prince is also used to doing everyday tasks. On Vancouver Island, he and Meghan live like a regular young couple with a young child. According to the prince, the military prepared him for a no-frills existence. You forget, I was in the military for 10 years, so I'm more normal than my family would like to believe, he quipped during a leaked phone call. But certainly being in a different position now gives us the ability to say things and do things that we might not have been able to do. And seeing as everyone under the age of 35 or 36 seems to be carrying out an activist's role, gives us the opportunity to try and make more of a difference without being criticized. Oh no, I think it's much better. Royal experts believe Prince Harry will find non-royal life too challenging. Most royal fans and experts believe that the prince is making a grave error, and that he will deeply regret his decision to choose his wife's peace and happiness over his family. I hope after a year he rethinks and comes back and rejoins the firm, royal photographer Arthur Edwards told us. He's a boy who's never had to worry about parking his car. He's never had to worry about sorting out his tax returns or his insurance. All of this is going to be new to him. No one is going to do that for him now. He's either going to have to do it himself, or employ someone to do it. He's going to find life, as most of us do, pretty tough. He's 35 and he's never had to do anything like that, and he may wish he'd never gone down that road.
Please support growing LMT Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. If you have any suggestions for us, please leave your comments below. Thank you.
Don't stop.